beginning. We all come to a story with hopes and expectations, looking for an answer. Sometimes it would be better to live with that hope without ever knowing the full story. In a horror story, there are only victims and monsters. And the trick is not to end up as either. But trapped by the genre, we are all ripped to pieces along the way. This is not the story I hoped it would be. This is not the ending I wanted. This story will eat us alive. This story is a monster. Monsters wear many faces.
Kiddo, how are you?
I'm good, Mom. How are you?
This trip might take a little longer than I thought. I'm sorry I've been gone so much lately, Logan.
Oh my god, Mom, it's not your fault. People get all murdery. What happened?
Just work stuff.
Right. Well, Dad and I are just watching the latest episode of Night Springs here. Mom, it's so good.
No spoilers! I'll let you get back to the show. You were supposed to wait and watch with me. I love you both.
This is what happens when you go on work trips, Mom. Love you too. And say hi to Casey. Tell him to stop brooding so much.
Logan? I will. Bye, kiddo. Logan thinks you should try cheering up.
Snarky kid. Wonder where she gets that from.
It can't be a coincidence that another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Feels like the killer's leaving us a message.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. It's right up your alley. You should take lead. Think of me as the backup.
Okay. Any words of advice?
Nothing that would cheer anyone up.
To work. everyone, Dragon Souls here. Welcome back to Alan Wake 2. Now I had to take me a little break because I had to figure out I didn't look it up or anything. I just need to figure this out. Let's see, I'll be damn. Hold on. Well, I think I already got this one here, that's why it's not working. Aha. Uh-huh.
Dream of calling it quits. Hmm? Making a clean break. Retiring. Escaping. Leaving all this sordid misery and terror behind. Getting in a car and driving till you see the sunrise. Somewhere where the sun still rises. Settling down, buying a house, fixing it up, building a life, finding someone. It's a fool's dream. It would all go bad. And having let hope in, it would be unbearably worse than this. You can take the man out of the city, but you can never take the city out of the man.
That's true. That is so true. You can take the man out of the city, but you can take the net. You can never take the city out of the man. Just like country, you can take the country. You can take a country boy and a country boy or a country guy and guy or girl, whoever, out of the country.
I could use that shotgun.
But you can never take the city out of the person. Okay, I need to handgun. Okay, I need to start using some of these. I'm gonna have to do this. I hate to do it.
The barman, you caught my eye.
Where is that one place? It's over there. I have. Dang it, I really hate to waste it. Okay. Ah, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I still can't. It's gonna take two of those things. Okay, I mean, we'll move this over here. As much as I need to do it, I'm gonna have to use it. You gotta be fucking kidding me. I'm trying to... Okay, I'm gonna have to definitely put the, go back for a minute and get some I gotta go over here. I gotta put some of that stuff in the box. So I can get that shotgun. Yeah, I'll put this in there instead. Let me save right here. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker! The trophy didn't say that, but I just had to put it in there. Whoa! Well, at least I did save it. At least I fucking saved. Oh, it saved it right there. So, okay. Motherfucker's trying to stop me. I know Daryl's gonna love that when I said that. He's one of my best friends.
The room was empty except for the projector. More games. Was the film a message waiting to be played?
This temple. shadow and mist. There's a window in the floor and a door in the ceiling. There's no knowing. Am I standing still or running or kneeling?
You're the one who's been calling me.
Indeed. I'm Tom Zane. Welcome to the House of Zane.
The poet. The diver. You look like me. How the hell...
Or maybe. You look like me, you handsome devil. The diver was a beloved character I played in one of my films. I'm a filmmaker. A celebrated auteur.
I need answers. Why is return so important? What...
Al... You always get worked up like this. Come on, I'll fix you a drink. We're in this together. Two artists collaborating, remember? Crafting the keys to our escape. Your magnum opus, Return, and its companion piece, my film. Sharing our life-altering visions, a melding of higher minds. Dreaming up our transcendental work of art. Here, in this room. 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 In this room.
It's return, but because we return.
And that is how the magic happened.
Enough of this bullshit. Alice is in danger. I need another murder site to go further. Back to Parliament Tower. Scratches!
Your wife is safe back in the real New York. But Scratch is reaching for her through an overlap. Return is the key to escaping the dark place. You need to get it before that freak does. There's a murder site here in the hotel. Let the waves of your writing carry you there.
Hello?
They're on to us. If anyone asks, you were never here.
Thomas Zane had ended our talk in what felt like a paranoid fit. I had what I needed from him. There was another murder site in the hotel to guide me further toward my escape. I had to write my way to it.
Whispers from the police radio kept me awake at night. The word through the ether. A murder in the backdrop of a play featuring a murder cult. How meta can you get? He said, looking knowingly at the camera. I could sense the cult of the word in this, and their leader, Mr. Scratch. Rumored to be Alan Wake, the writer who'd gone missing years before.
The hotel was a perfect setting for a Casey story. I was on the right path.
Let's see, Doug, yeah. Yeah, I did. Investigate, okay, now. Before we go any further with that, there, let's go back out there so we can go in there and do investigation on that. Okay. We only missed that in there, which is okay on that. And that we missed. So I'm not gonna go back and get none of that, cause we also missed this one here. I think I know what's that, but then again I don't. Okay, so I can't switch it over here. All right.
Set the mood where everyone had come in. The victim, the murderer, the detective. An idea, clear as a vision, waited for me here.
play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power. You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, he will come.
The pre-show ritual. That's it. Set it up. Start from the beginning.
All right. Find the site of the pre-show ritual. I look like shotgun shells and I can't use them.
Was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. Thank you.
Usually the keys would be in the office.
I couldn't get in. I was missing something.
Yeah, we're missing the key.
Busy building their own wicker man,
where
they themselves would be sacrificed.
Okay. I think we need to put this over here for right now. Okay, perhaps I should have never done that. Perhaps I should have kept my shotgun. Okay, I'll definitely keep my shotgun with me.
special place, a shifting space, existing in a countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town, sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream, always in the universe. These are the stories that take place there. More inspiring, macabre, terrifying, heartbreaking, nail-biting, absurd, and thrilling. Sometimes all of these things at once. A haunting new season of mind-bending episodes written by Alan Wake. I am your host, Orland Orr, and I will see you soon in Night Springs.
Oh, but goddamn it. How many, you mean to tell me it takes 10 bullets to kill up and kill him? Seriously, you might well say it takes 1,500 bullets to kill him. No, I forgot. It takes 5 million bullets to kill him. They can't be killed. Damaged our story. You damaged our story. No, I didn't destroy nothing. You doing it yourself, you cocking back here. need to put that gun back. Go back and save and put that gun back in there. Okay,
countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town. Sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us.
Let's look and see here. Battery. Flashbang. Break room. Thank you.
was locked from the other side. It could not be opened on this side. I didn't have the key.
The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play. Changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed.
Lucky shot, sorry.
whispers from the police radio kept me awake at night. The word through the ether. A murder in the backdrop of a play featuring a murder cult. How meta can you get? He said, looking knowingly at the camera. I could sense the cult of the word in this, and their leader, Mr. Scratch. Rumored to be Alan Wake, the writer who'd gone missing years before. So you were the director of this play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power. You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, he will come.
Oh, man, that went down the wrong tube.
This city will suck you dry if you stay here for too long. You'll end up a lost soul haunting the streets and alleys, a faded out shadow. Glimpsed by some other poor bastard on his way toward the same fate. Your broken dreams become a broken mirror, and the reflection staring back at you with all the pent-up anger, regret, guilt, and shame was the monster you could never get away from. You dream of calling it quits, making a clean break, retiring, escaping, leaving all this sordid misery and terror behind. Getting in a car and driving till you see the sun rise. Somewhere where the sun rises. Settling down, buying a house. Fixing it up, building a life. Finding someone. It's a fool's dream. It would all go bad. And having let hope in, it would be unbearably worse than this. You can take the man out of the city, but you can never take the city out of the man.
That is so true. Whoa.
I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene.
Alright, I have to figure out what happened in the back. Ballroom. Hmm. I don't know if what the hell am I supposed to do. Oh. Dale Lumpkins, hi bud. Hey there bud, welcome to the stream. welcome to the stream. Ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. Okay, room 20, move to room 202. Room 219, 202.
This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began.
Visitors. Okay, I'm back. Interrogate both of them. We had to look through both of them. Please. I don't see nothing in here I need to do.
Set up a play in a hotel. Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel, yes. That's a trope for a reason.
set up a play in a hotel. Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap?
We don't see nothing here we need to do. Just perform the summoning in the ballroom. How's the ballroom at now? Oh yeah, there it is. Fortunately for you, I can't stop you.
Recognize my writer's room on the stage. I almost dreaded the ideas this would conjure up.
What was the nice set you got here? What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess, Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you, but turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was, shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that.
Mm-hmm. Ah, oh, shit. Shit, it's getting real. Okay, now we gotta redo the whole fucking thing again. Arthur, hey there, bud. Welcome to the stream. New game plus release for Alan Wake 2 today. Nope. Y'all wish. This game ain't free for PS Plus. I wish. I have think everybody wishes that. Alright, what do I gotta do now? That's what I thought. Oh, perform the summoning in the bell room, okay. Here's what I gotta do. Yeah, straight ahead. Yeah, this game ain't free for PS Plus. Whoops, wrong one, wrong place. Shoot, if it was, a lot of people would be buying and getting it for free right now. Okay. Alright everyone, well that's definitely going to be it for this last stream for now and probably for today. I have no idea just yet. Thank you all so very much for watching live on stream or on demand. If I do come back, it'll be probably in a couple hours when I do. Of Alan Wake 2. If not, then later on tonight it'll be more grinding of Lords of the Fallen. See then if I do more of Alan Wake 2. 800 subscribers.
Me now, subscribe.